What up, what up, what up? What is going on, ladies and gentlemen, and pets of all ladies? You boys, welcome back to another Madden 25 Online Ranked Match. And today, another 25 Online Ranked Match. And today, another Madden 25 Online Ranked Match. And today, it's been a while, baby. It's been a while. We have the Oakland Raiders going up against the Kansas City Chiefs. So definitely, two teams that might not be the best. Well, never mind. Let me rephrase that. The Raiders may not be the best in overall, but they're definitely a good team. As we take off the kickoff, it looks like he can go. Oh, you're a hater, yo. The Raiders aren't the best in overall, but we know as far as Madden-wise, they're definitely a very, very good team. The Chiefs as well are a very, very dominant team. Great linebackers, good secondary, good just pass rush. Monstrous running back, obviously, with the light-skinned Jamal Charles. And we're going to try our best to bottle him up. You know what I'm saying? We can work on bottling up Jamal Charles. You know, try not to let him get in open space. Try and force him to pass. And try our best to keep Jamal Charles out of the game. If we can do that, I feel like we could be successful. Right there, hits me with Buck Sweep on 3rd and 12. Obviously, I'm not expecting a run on 3rd and 12. That's definitely a passing situation. But only in the world in Madden where you can just do a Buck Sweep on 3rd and 12 and pick up a first down. So, got to keep that in mind. And you know, can't blame them. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I wasn't expecting it. But can't blame putting the ball in your best playmaker's hands and hoping for, you know, this right here. Just pancakes all over the place, good blocking. Find a seam and just let them run loose. So, 7-7, you know, after that first possession, like, okay, we got to worry about some Buck Sweeps. We got to try our best to go on ahead and... When you're playing against, right there, we hit him with the back joker right here. Moore looks like he could go. I mean, to be anyway, you get tackled. When you're going up against somebody who likes to do Buck Sweeps or strong powers, anything with two pulling guards, you want to be able to, have those linemen commit early. You know what I mean? Because if those guys can reach the outside, then you know the play becomes OP and very, you know, your defense becomes vulnerable. You know what I mean? You do not want those linemen hitting the outside. You want them to be able to commit inside. So, you know, I got to do my best to make sure that they pick up a body before they can reach the outside. So, you know, anytime you go up against Buck Sweep, strong power, it's a little difficult, but it is, you know, stoppable. Right there, just my fault, flat out bad read by me. And as you guys see or maybe have noticed, I am running Kansas City in this play. So, in this game. So, we're running Kansas City playbook. I would love to know if you guys could do me a favor. Let me know in the comments section if either you guys have been using it and if it's been successful. Hopefully, it has been. Or if you guys have been going against it. Of course, every time I drop a scheme, there's always good and bad. There's always, hey, this scheme has helped me out tremendously. It's awesome. Thank you. Appreciate it. And there's always, damn you, GS, you homo. Now I got to go up against this nonsense, man. Damn it. So let me know if you guys have been going up against some KC5 wide or you guys have been using it. I would love to know if it's, you know, hopefully been benefiting you. And I would like to know. So as you guys saw, it's FMB and we eat some dirt, son. And we recovered that. So I would... you know, I noticed he punted on 4th and 1. Not too many people do that. As right here, we go to the out. Did you really just drop a wide open out route? Did you really have an out route right at your disposal and dropped it? You disgust me. You flat out disgust me. Like, if I ever seen him in real life, if he just came, I don't even remember who it was who dropped. I don't even know his name. But I'm after I do his commentary, I'm going to find out his name, and I'm keeping it in the back of my mind forever. If I ever happen to go, I go to Walmart. He's like, hey, you know, Joe Schmo. Oh, wait a minute. Ain't you Joe Schmo who played back in the Raiders? Yo, in Madden 25, you dropped a wide open out route. You disgust me. Then I'm a super soak him in the face with some palm olive dish detergent non-scented. See, usually I go scented because I feel nice. You know what I'm saying? Let him smell like some peach mango, some sunflower breeze, some summer scent, something like, no, unscented. So you ain't gonna smell like nothing. It's just gonna burn your eyes. My eyes. This must be unscented palm olive. It is, you bastard. Stop jumping up, Rose. So anyways, 14-7, we have the lead right here. This time, 4th down, he decides to go for it, goes to another power run, and then he hits the outside. Jamal Charles into the spin move, breaks a couple tackles, and then he ends up taking it all the way to the end zone. I'm like, damn, damn, damn. So many touchdowns we are giving up to these runs. And I'm like, all right, we got to be able to stop them. We're going to have difficult time all game long if Jamal Charles continues to eat us alive like this. If we cannot take him out of his game plan, then I don't see me having too much of a, you know, successful time being able to win this game. I need to be able to remove Jamal Charles from his game plan to be able to make it easier for me to win this game. So, a minute left right now. We got less than a minute. We're trying to move the ball with the rope. Probably doesn't have the best accuracy in the world, but in Madden, he throws pretty well. So, right here, I'm rerouting people, trying to get somebody open. I'm running to the outside. I go over the middle, and he drops the pass. I'm like, no. Why are we dropping so many passes, man? Second and 10 right here. We drop back. We're looking. And we hit him with the skinny. Right over the middle. I know he wasn't expecting it. So right there, we get ourselves a first down. And whoop, we hit him with the whoop. And we hit him with the read option. Looks like we can. Whoa. Oh, oh, he's alive. He's alive. And I slid. I slid. Whoop, there you go. Waste them timeouts, baby. Waste them timeouts. Because we all know GS before halftime has defensive awareness equals of that of a remote control. Just zero. We all know I'm ass when it comes to defense before halftime. So I'm trying to give him the best, trying to give myself the best opportunity to stop him. So we don't score the touchdown. Best case scenario happened right there. We scored the touchdown anyways, and we got him to waste a couple of timeouts. So now he has one timeout and a couple 30 seconds left to be able to drive downfield. And that's how you know when your running game is just OP. His running game is slapping me silly, and you call, you know, you got one timeout, just 30 seconds left, and you call a buck sweep. That just lets you know how dominant his run has been this game. So right now, I'm trying to get in field goal range, and right here, oh, you know what we're going to, baby? You know what we're going to? We're going to the passing game, baby! No extra prize, that's what we do in KC, son! We pass the ball! And then right there, another quick little pass right there, but out of bounds. You know, we just need a couple yards right here. We go to the 5-wide QB draw. I was just hoping for, you know, maybe a handful of yards, and we got that. We're easily in field goal range for Seabass right there. Sebastian Janikowski, who has a tremendous kick power. And we end up kicking the field goal. We go up 10, and that was big because he did receive ball out of halftime. So we are up a multiple possessions, and that's always big. That's always the situation I try to put myself in any single game. Because if I'm up multiple possessions, no matter what he does on offense, I get the ball back with the lead. Doesn't matter if he scores. It's up to my offense for me to win that game from then on out. As soon as I go up multiple possessions, it's up to my offense to finish the game. If I score every time I get the ball, he's not going to be able to win. So he continues to run the ball down my throat, having tremendous success doing it. And again, I'm frustrated. I'm not going to lie at this point. But I'm less frustrated at the fact that, like I said, I got that two-possession lead. And looking for it in the outside. And this time he could go away as we scamper on into the end zone. Whoop! Look at that lazy-ass jump right there. Look at that lazy-ass jump. So 31-21, we end up scoring. Our first touchdown of the second half without even having to put our offense on the field, which is big. So here we go back again on defense. He's continuing to do these strong powers, buck sweeps, these runs with the two pulling guards. He's getting Jamal Charles to the outside. Look, 14 rushes for 260 yards, just absolutely dominating this defense. And it doesn't help that I'm controlling the defense. Look at pancakes all over the place, just really having trouble stopping the run. And, you know, it's not like I don't know how to stop these runs or whatever. So don't think if you play me, you're going to be able to just do all this and have success. Yeah, he's doing it. But I know how to stop the runs, but I'm hard-headed. You know what I mean? I always feel like you're going to do something what I'm expecting you not to do. You know what I mean? Did I say that right? You know what I mean? So I'm expecting you to do what, you know, you're – damn it, I don't know how to word. Damn it. If you run the ball 100 times and you score a touchdown every single time, I'm still preparing for the pass. I'm like, there's going to be that one time where you're going to slip up and not run the ball. So, you know, I'm still preparing for passes. I'm still sending pass blitzes. I'm not calling the defense that I know works stopping buck sweeps. But I'm just preparing for a different play, even though he's destroying me with the run. He's not going to anything different. But like I said, I'm hard-headed. You know, then I'll go on ahead, I'll prepare for the run, and that one time he'll pass the ball, and then I just get super frustrated. So I'm still in my pass defense, and I shouldn't be. I know I shouldn't be, but again, I'm stubborn like that, and it's not working for me. So right here on 4th-and-4, good bat down right there. We decided to play it safe and try and get ourselves last possession. So I'm expecting it's going to be tough for him to kill the entire clock from here with four stoppages. You know, potential four stoppages. You know, we got a two-minute warning, plus I have all of my timeouts. Right there, hits me with the juke, and it looks like he's going to be able to take it all the way. We get a diving effort, and we miss. Another diving effort, and we miss. And that right there was the worst-case scenario. Why? Because not only I don't care about to give him the lead because I don't feel like he's going to be able to stop me, but now the situation is reversed. It's very difficult for me to waste this entire time left. So it looks like he's going to be able to have last possession. So that right there makes me a little nervous, the fact that my defense may be on the field last. And obviously, I never want to be in a situation where it's up to my defense to win me the game. I'd much rather depend on my offense. So, of course, I'm trying to waste as much time as possible. Like I said, him having 2-minute warning plus three timeouts is going to be tough to waste 4 minutes of a clock. So I'm just trying to take off as much time as possible. That way, when he does get ball, hopefully he doesn't have too much time remaining to be able to drive downfield. So right here, we hit him with the read option again. And right there, we just slide. All we need is the field goal. We're playing it safe. 2-minute warning already passed. He's refusing to call his timeouts. And right there was great. We actually were able to go on ahead and milk the entire clock. With the first down right here, we are able to do that, I should say, if we're get a first down. That's exactly what happens. Out route right there, there's nothing he can do. Game is absolutely over. We are in field goal range. We call a knee, waste his last time out, so we kick the game-winning field goal. And I, like I said, I was not expecting to waste all that much time having the ball last. I was definitely expecting him to have ball last, but it worked out in my favor to where I was actually lucky enough to have the ball last. This is a game where whoever had the ball last was most likely going to win, and I was fortunate enough that it was me. So definitely, you know, good opponent taking advantage of those runs that are, you know, very, look at that, 6 passing yards, 300 yards passing. But nonetheless, you could run for 1,000 yards on me. As long as I win the game, I could care less, you know what I mean? So you went ahead, had a dominant game offensively, but, you know, like I said, we were dominant offensively as well. We came up with big games. And we check out his record. He had a very good, solid record. So we end up winning, and we're happy about that. So that's the end of the gameplay, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. As always, man, love each and every single one of you guys, man. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. It's your boy, Jess. I'm out. Peace. Give it to me, baby.